Hello children, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe at home. Welcome to online classes. This side Khushbu Rijwani from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group, Kota. Students, today I am here to teach you environmental studies. And today we are going to revise chapter number 5, My Family and Me, and chapter number 6, My Sweet Home. Okay children, now take out page number 27. My Family and Me. Children, before revising book work and notebook work, we will revise this chapter in brief. What is family and what are the types of families? Children, we all live in a family. Group of people who live together is called a family, in which father, mother, brother and sister live, and these all are called our family members. Now, like for example, child, you have a name, your mother has different name, your father has different name, your brother and sister also have their different names. These are your special names, but your last name is common. You all have a same last name, that is your surname. It belongs to whole family. In some families, grandparents, uncles, aunt and siblings also live. Now these families are divided into two categories, that is nuclear family and joint family. Now what is nuclear family? Nuclear family may be a big or a small family, but in that family only father, mother and children live. A family in which father, mother and children live is called a nuclear family. Next is joint family. In joint means large. In joint family, grandparents, parents, uncles, aunts and siblings live. Who are grandparents? Grandparents are your parents' parents. They are old and wise. They love you. They tell you stories. They bring gifts for you. And who are siblings? Siblings are your cousins who share toys with you, who have fun with you, who care for you, who help you when you need them. Joint family is a large family. A family in which all these people live is called a joint family. Now I hope this chapter is clear to you. Now we will revise book work of this chapter. Children, you will revise it with me. Question number first, write true or false. The elders in the family earn money. Now children, in your family, who works to earn money? Your father and mother. And who are they? Who are them? They are your elders. So who works to earn money? Elders. So this statement is true. You will write true over here. You teach your parents good things. Now children, you know, your family, your home is the first school where your parents teach you good things. So who teaches you good things? Your parents. You don't teach them. So this statement is false, because your parents teach you good things before you come to school, when you are 3 to 4 years old. Before that, when you where you learn good habits? At your home. And who teaches good things to you? Your parents. Grandparents are your parents' parents. Is it true or false? Who are your parents' parents? Your grandparents. So this statement is true. A nuclear family is a large family. Is nuclear family a large family? No. Large means a family in which grandparents, parents, uncle, aunts and children live together. But in nuclear family only father, mother and children live. So nuclear family is a small family. So this statement is false. We will write false over here. I hope you must have revised this thing with me. Now we will revise notebook work of this chapter. Let's see. Who all live together in a joint family? I told you, I explained you now, who all live together in a joint family? Let's see the answer. Parents, grandparents, uncles, aunts and children live together in a joint family. So many people live together in a joint family. That is why it is called joint family, na? Grandparents, parents, uncle, aunts and children. Question number 2. How do you enjoy with your siblings. How do you enjoy with your siblings? We play, share our toys and have fun with our siblings. Now how we enjoy? You share things with them na? When you bring gifts from outside, you share with them, you play with them, you enjoy with them. So answer is we play, we share our toys and have fun with our siblings. Now we will learn some hard words of this chapter. First word we will learn is parents. You will speak with me. P-A-R-E-N-T-S. Parents. Who are parents? Father and mother. Next is grandparents. G-R-A-N-D. Grand. P-A-R-E-N-T-S. Grandparents. Now who are grandparents? Your parents' parents. Uncles. U-N-C-L-E-S. Aunts. A-U-N-T-S. Aunts. Now what do you do with your siblings? We play, share our toys. Now the spelling of share is S-H-A-R-E. Share. And have fun with our siblings. Okay. Now I hope this chapter is clear to you children. Now we will revise chapter number 6, My Sweet Home. So children, take out your books and open page number 3030. In this chapter we are going to revise why do we need a house, what are the different rooms in a house and how to make home a good home. Okay children, now you know every living being needs a house because it gives a shelter from rain, hot sun, robbers and wild animals. We have different rooms in our house and each room has we do different activity in each room. First is bedroom. What we do in bedroom? When we are sleepy and when we need to take rest, we take rest in bedroom. Okay, next is kitchen. Kitchen is a place where your mama cooks delicious food for you. Third is dining room, where you sit and have your meal. You sit and have your meal in dining room. In dining room, you have a dining table and a chair. You have dining table and chairs. Next is drawing room. Now, children, when guests come at your place, where you attend your guest? You attend your guest in drawing room. Do you take them to bedroom or you take them to kitchen? No, you attend your guest in the drawing room. Last is bathroom. Bathroom is a place where you brush your teeth or you take shower. These are different rooms in a house. Now we will see how to make home a good home. Children, first of all you should always keep this thing in mind that home should be airy. And to make home airy, we should always open doors and windows because doors and windows let the fresh air enter into the house. Second, we should always rub our shoes on the foot mat when we enter the house. Third, we should always switch off lights and fan when we leave the room. If you drop or spill something, you should always tell your parents. You should always remove the cobwebs. Now what are cobwebs? Cobwebs are the webs made by spiders. You should flush the toilet after use. So these are some points by which you can make your home a good home. I hope you must have understood this chapter well with me. Now we will revise bookwork of this chapter. Children, open page number 3333. Let's see. Write the action word. We have to write the correct action word. Action words are given over here. Let's see. Dash the waste into the dustbin. Where we should throw the waste? We should always throw the waste in the dustbin. So the answer is T-H-R-O-W, throw. Dash the floor. Okay children, you know we should always keep our surroundings clean. How can we keep our surroundings clean? By cleaning, grooming, by sweeping the floor. So the answer is SWEEP, sweep. Dash the cobwebs. What we should do? We should always remove the cobweb because we have to keep our surrounding clean. We have to keep our home a good home. So we should always remove, remove the cobwebs. Dash the toilet after use. What we should do after using washroom, after using toilet, we should always flush. So the answer is FLUSH, flush. Dash your parents if you drop something. Children, I told you, if you spill or drop something, what you should do? You should tell your parents. So answer is TELL, tell. Match the following. Now let's see dustbin, cobweb, toilet and sink. Okay, what we throw it in the dustbin? The garbage which we collect. How we collect? How do we clean the floor? With the help of the broom. So the answer is BROOM, broom. Number one on broom. Cobweb. Now who makes cobweb? Cobweb are the webs made by spider. SPIDER, spider. Toilet. What we should always do after using toilet? We should always flush the toilet. So answer is FLUSH, flush. Sink. Okay. When you have your meal, where you keep your utensils and where your mama cleans the utensils? In the sink. Mama wash utensils in the sink. So answer is WASH, wash. I hope you must have learned this book work with me. Now we will revise notebook work of this chapter. How can we make a house airy? We can make a house airy by opening the windows and doors every day. Children, I told you a good home is when it is airy. And how it can be airy? By opening doors and windows every day, because it lets the fresh air enter into our house and sunlight also. How can children keep their home clean? Write two ways. Now how can you keep your home clean? We have to write two ways. There are many ways, but here we will write two ways how to make our home clean. Children can keep their home clean by throwing the waste into the dustbin. We should always throw the waste into the dustbin because it makes our surroundings clean. Keeping their clothes, shoes and books in place. We should always keep our things in proper place. Our room should not be messy. It should be neat and clean. Now I hope you must have revised this chapter. We will see hard words of this chapter. Let's see. Okay, first spelling is FLUSH, flush. We should always flush the toilet after use. Second is remove, REMOVE, remove. We should always remove the cobwebs. Okay, what we should open to let the fresh air enter into our house? Doors and windows. DOORS, doors. WINDOWS, windows. Okay, who make cobwebs? Cobwebs are made by spiders. So the spelling of spiders is SPIDERS, spiders. Okay, I hope this chapter is also clear. Children, now I hope you must have revised both the chapters, book work, notebook work. Keep learning and keep revising. Thank you.